everyone, so today I'm doing a quick review and a demo on how to use the brand new, oh my god, I'm really crazy about these, the NYX eyebrow gels, sorry. I have the shade Blonde, Chocolate, and Espresso, so it's 1, 2, and 4. Today I'm going to be using this, and I'm going to show you how I'm going to fill in my eyebrows using this. Here they are, so this is Blonde, this is Chocolate, and this is Espresso. You get 10 milliliters or 0.3 ounces of product in each of these. This is a lot of product. I'm telling you, this is going to last you longer than the 9 months you can keep it open. This is also really great. It's cruelty-free, and the container, if I understood correctly, is also recyclable. Now, I'm going to be swatching these products on my hand so you guys can see what they look like. So these are three shades. This is Blonde, Chocolate, and Espresso. As you can see, Blonde and Espresso have more of an ashy undertone, while Chocolate has a red undertone. I got the three shades because using this not only myself but on my clients, I can kind of get everyone's eyebrow shade with this, unless someone has a much darker shade than Espresso. I think there's one more shade that's like black, but I don't know. Like, there's very rare clients I work with that have that dark eyebrows. Usually they're going to fit between these three shoe shades. So this is why I chose the three, because I think that just combining these three, you can get whatever you want. And I'm just gonna smudge them a little bit. So this is Blonde. You can see really, like, it's really nice for Blonde. It's ashy. This is Chocolate. I'm gonna just drag it out like this here. Where you can see, it does have an ashy undertone, but it also has a red, kind of like a real chocolatey red hue to it. And the last one is Espresso. So those are the three shades when we kind of smudge them. When I first got the package, what I did is I took the lightest shade, which is Blonde, and I did fill in my eyebrows. These products currently are only available in the US. They are not available at all in Europe. I'm not sure about the rest of the world, but I know that now it's exclusively and only for the next few months, maybe longer. Now, these products I have been reading on a lot of professional makeup artists forums and private groups on Facebook, where people have been really bragging about this product. I even did read a blog post about this. This is the reason I actually did buy, because I read a blog post from another beauty blogger that did say she preferred the NYX Cosmetics eyebrow gel over the Anastasia eyebrow gel, which comes in a small little container, something of like this one. It looks kind of, reminds me a lot of the like gel liners. I do know that Anastasia eyebrow gels are like the only thing which professional makeup artists use, and usually people that don't have well-defined eyebrows. So when I saw the comparison, because she compared Anastasia eyebrow, and she has a very oily skin like I do, and people with oily skin are basically the best guinea pigs when it comes to any product that claims that it is, let me read this, waterproof, long-lasting, and smudge-proof. So you know what? I was like, come on, those are three things which oily girls just kind of rarely get. So, and this girl had oily skin, and she did show how long that the Anastasia eyebrow gel lasted, and she did say that it was not smudge proof, the Anastasia brow gel, and that it kind of lasted not as long as she expected it to. And then she did she also had some other brand, I think it was Makeup Forever, and Makeup Forever's eyebrow gels, they come like in this small. She was very disappointed with them because she thought that Anastasia was better. And then she compared the new NYX brow gels, which we just saw today, and she said that that was the most long lasting. And I was like, you know what? That review is awesome, let me go get it. So I did buy it, and I did apply it, and I'm going to tell you that I am the type of person that touches my face a lot, and this is probably why I have sometimes acne. And I always touch my eyebrows, it's just kind of like automatic. I mean, if you actually think about it, you touch your face a lot, if you actually think about it. And I touch my eyebrows a lot, just, I don't know why, it just kind of happens. Apply the brow gel at 10 a.m. and I kept it on until 8 p.m. and then I took it off. I touch my eyebrows a lot. I basically, like, you know, like smudge them like this and so on. And I have every other eyebrow. I usually use my pencils for Simga Beauty and the eyebrow wax and the eyebrow gel, and maybe not the wax, sorry, not the wax, but the eyebrow gel and the eyebrow shadows to kind of make this last long. And I even do fix it with my fixer spray. Of course, everything falls off my face after a few hours. This guy, these puppies, I was specifically using just the lightest shade, which, anywho, this lasted from 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. Did it fade? Yes. Did it smudge? No. Was it long lasting? Oh yes. My opinion are that these kicked ass from Anastasia. I'm telling you, these are better and these are cheaper. And if you have like these little holes like I do in your eyebrow eyebrows, these puppies will amaze you. These guys last all day. They did fade a little bit. Yes, of course, every product fades. There's no such thing as a super long lasting product that just won't move. I'm so impressed with it that I really do recommend everyone get them. So I'm going to be showing you how I fill in my eyebrows with these and only using these. I mean, I'm still like kind of experimenting with them. So this is kind of like a trial of how I do it, but this is how I'm going to be doing it. I'm first going to be applying it on the back of my hand, just a little dot. That's, as you can see, I'm sorry, my hand's a little dirty. It's just, as you can see, it's very hard to take it off. So I apply a little bit on the back of my hand. I'm taking my small Inga brush E65 from Sigma, and I'm just gonna be picking it up like that. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just going to lightly fill in the mild gaps. Work fast with it because it really does dry fast. So I'm just kind of filling in my eyebrows naturally. The only issue is that like you will need different thicknesses of brushes to make this work. So with the lightest shade, as you can see, what I do is I kind of just give I kind of just fill in my eyebrows. And now I'm going to be mixing that lightest shade with the darkest shade Espresso to kind of get like a middle shade. Just a little bit, as you can see. A little bit also of chocolate because my eyebrows are not like, they have a little bit of a red pigment to them. So there's three shades right there. I'm just gonna be adding a little bit more of the lightest shade blonde just so that they're not too dark because there's two dark shades. And now I'm going to be using that brush that I used earlier and I'm just gonna mix the three shades up. I got like a medium, really nice, warm, ashy warm shade. And now I'm going to go and take my Illamasqua, what's it called, angled brush. And I'm going to be taking that to actually give definition to my eyebrows. And the reason I'm using Illamasqua's brush is because there's no brush as thin as Illamasqua's eyebrow brush, and this is amazing. We're going to be defining, as if I was drawing them out, I'm going to be defining, oh my God, that's kind of quite dark, hold on. I'm going to be defining my eyebrows now. And if you can, smudge the edges. I like doing the ombre effect, so that's why my eyebrows, it's okay if they're darker at the edges or something. Wipe off any excess so that I only have a very light coat of that. See, like, I'm still learning how to work with this. Because if you don't work fast enough, it actually it dries up really fast. Now I'm going to be taking a very small brush from e.l.f. It's the concealer brush from e.l.f. It's really nice, it's small. And I'm going to be applying a little bit more of blonde on the back of my hands. And I'm just going to be mixing it with the shade which I just applied. Which I just made, I'm sorry, with those three shades, just to kind of get a lighter version of that eyebrow gel which we made. And the reason I'm doing that is because I want to define my eyebrows here in front. And it's a little bit too defined right there, so I'm just going to wipe off this brush and smudge it. Taking another clean angled brush I have, I'm going to be smudging this all right there. So this is the way that I define my eyebrows currently. I'm still working with these gels because I'm not used to kind of a gel form with kind of like, it's more like a, not liquidy, but kind of like something between gel and liquid. And I'm still kind of working with this, but this is the way that I'm going to do it. Right now, they might be a little bit more defined than what I would usually do. But this is it. Combining those three shades, I get my ideal shade, which is something like, which is actually great for my eyebrows. And thank you guys so much for watching. Please leave a comment below. Tell me if you bought these products and which shades are you looking to get. If you need a recommendation as to which shade to get, please leave a comment below. I'll gladly help you. Don't forget to share this video if you enjoyed it. Like, as I said, comment, and follow me on my Instagram for sneak peeks of upcoming makeup tutorials. Thank you guys. Bye.